It's crazy when you think about all the different kinds of foods we eat. We just swallow and hope it all works out for the best. Well, as it turns out, there are better ways to think about keeping our bodies humming healthfully along. Welcome to the Nutrition Facts Podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Michael Greger. Today, we answer a wide variety of your questions like the importance of a good breakfast smoothie, what kind of scientific study I'd like to see performed, and we start with an interesting question from Keen about whether there have been any updates on the therapeutic use of psychedelics.
So psychedelics was on my list of topics. It's so fascinating, such an incredible area. There's finally been some placebo-controlled trials. You say, wait a second, how do you do a placebo-controlled trial? Right? You kind of notice when you're on mushrooms or whatever. But no, how about we anesthetize people, make people unconscious, then give them mushrooms or not? They have no idea when they wake up afterwards whether they were on mushrooms or not. Does it actually change your brain? Does it actually do anything? Or do you actually need to have that component? So many interesting questions. I wanted to do a deep dive into this, so the whole ketamine stuff, and I really wanted to cover it all. Is there, you know, is MDMA going to hurt our brains? And just so many questions that I just don't know the answers to, and I was eager to find out. I get a lot of questions about it. So I have about 300 meg worth of PDFs, a couple hundred articles on ayahuasca, LSD, mescaline, microdosing, talking about safety. So I have the research. It's there. I just have to read it and write it, and unfortunately it all fell down before I was able to jump on it. Any data, this is actually something I looked into. This is, what do they call it? Like, it's not a seaweed, it's actually like grows on the shores, but like in brackish water, so it actually pulls up salt. So it's like this salty moss or something, this plant that has a high salt content. And so it's a way to add salt to a food secretly. Pickle weed? Anyway, so there was a whole food plant-based muffin mix company that, like, well, wait a second. How do you have a whole food plant-based muffin? Well, what can you use for sweetener? Well, you can use date powder, right? Whole food. But what do you use for salt? Anyone who's baked, you know, you add salt to bake goods to, you know, change flavor profile. If it's whole food plant-based, there can't be any salt in it. And so what they used is they used this this ingredient. And so I was like, oh, all right, well, let's look it up. And so they're effectively just adding salt. I mean, I forget, it's like 30% of the weight of this plant is pure salt. It just sucks up the salt from the seawater. And so, I mean, you look at the sodium, it's off the charts as you'd expect, as if you just added salt. So it's kind of a sneaky way. And so I contacted them. I was like, you can't do this. You can't get away with this. And so they actually changed it, to potassium chloride, which is the way to do it. You move from sodium salt to potassium salt. So that's the way you can actually cut down on sodium. So I would not eat this really salty plant, even though it's like a whole food, right? But it's too much sodium. If you want your food salty, use potassium chloride, or season it in a way where you don't need it so salty. Tyler says, if I make a smoothie with 80% of my vitamin mineral intake in it, will absorb the nutrients that I need. Well, I mean, it depends on your vitamin mineral status. Your body actually, you know, if you're low on calcium, your body absorbs more calcium. You know, if you're low in iron, your body absorbs more iron, and vice versa. If you have too much iron, your body actually doesn't want too much, and so puts the brakes on. I mean, if you had one meal a day that had 100% of your nutrient needs, you would stay alive. You don't have to split it up through the day. Your body would, probably the first day, be like, whoa, one meal, we got all this manganese or whatever. But it'll eventually get to be like, oh, I guess that's what we're doing these days, one meal a day. And so I got to take my entire manganese, you know, allotment in this one meal, and it'll do it. Our body's pretty smart. I wouldn't worry about it. In fact, I think for a lot of people, the breakfast smoothie is probably the healthiest meal of the day. That's one of the great things about smoothies is you can do had all sorts of noxious stuff. My smoothie this morning had so many broccoli sprouts, it was almost too much. I've been trying to experiment with adding more and more broccoli sprouts. And it's like, I don't taste them at all. It's amazing, right? You mix it with the berries and, you know, and you just don't taste the broccoliness at all. Okay. You do. Today was the first day I was like, okay, my smoothie tastes like broccoli. But it was a lot of broccoli sprouts. Right. I would not want to eat that many broccoli sprouts throughout the day because it has a really kind of spicy flavor or radishy bite to it. Look, you smoke it in a smoothie. You can add all sorts of greens and the amla and stuff that's just normally nasty. So you could have just so much nutrition. And then even if you falter later in the day and, you know, then at least you got a good solid base. I'm down with that strategy. Although tomorrow I'm adding less broccoli sprouts. Let me see. HG. Oh, what am I eating today? So this morning I had my sprout disaster. So you make your own sprouts, broccoli sprouts, super easy to make. I think it's a quarter, 25 cents per cup, sprout them yourselves. So like on a nutrition per dollar basis, probably impossible to beat. I mean, maybe it's a good sweet potato comes close, but it's pretty amazing. The list of stuff I have in my smoothie, it would take all day. But for lunch, I had I knew I had 14 interviews today, so I didn't have time to actually make food. And so I have leftovers of a wonderful spaghetti sauce packed with veggies, got some artichoke hearts in there, and so had that on some whole wheat spaghetti. And then, supper. I'm going to do purple sweet potato fries. And then I don't know what else, but I'm excited for my purple sweet potato fries. They're so hard to, find in rural Virginia. Not all of us can, you know, live in big fancy cities. But I've found a source of purple sweet potatoes. I haven't had them in a while, so I'm super excited to make some fries. Anyway, all right, next up. Sillyhead, not one, not two, but Sillyhead 5 says, if I could see one study get performed, what would I want to put to the test? I'm a big fan. There's studies that would be really useful and interesting scientifically, but ultimately it's all about people making people's lives better. And so those are two different things. In terms of having an actual impact on the world, it would probably be, you know, a disease reversal study. I mean, that excites people. You do some basic science thing, which unveils some really interesting thing about some random enzyme. Maybe in 20 years that does something interesting to help people. But if you want the kind of bang for your buck right now, I've been working on How Not to Hurt, this pain management book through lifestyle. And there's this Plants for Joints, this series of amazing studies called Plants for Joints on osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis, randomizing people to a whole food plant-based diet and seeing remarkable benefits. And, you know, osteoarthritis is the leading cause of physical disability among older men and women. The fact that you can so improve pain and function just by changing people's diets, that is so cool. And so those are the kind of studies I would like to see where people within a matter of weeks, you know, they change their diet and not just their lab values change, but they actually, their day-to-day function changes. They can go up and down stairs without hurting. They can play with their grandkids more. And super common, not some rare little niche disease. That is a great, so I'd love to see, how about back pain studies? There haven't been any. So there haven't been any plant-based dietary intervention studies for back pain. There haven't been any randomized controlled dietary trials for back pain. There actually were. So I think there was a Mediterranean one. But I'd like to see plant-based since, blood flow through the vertebral arteries may indeed play a role in certain types of low back pain. It would be nice to see if you actually improve that circulation. Would you actually see some benefit? That hasn't been done. So yeah. So disease reversal studies, common chronic disease reversal studies, that can excite the imagination, grab headlines, and get people thinking, oh my God, get particularly physicians thinking, wow, you know, I have, you know, 100 people in my practice with this exact same condition that's really frustrating to treat. They I can't make them better. Every time they come to the office, I wish I could give them something, but you know, what am I going to do? Give them another opioids prescription or something? No. Now all of a sudden there's a tool to actually make people feel better. That's amazing. So that's the kind of study I would do. And unfortunately, we're out of time.
Visit nutritionfacts.org/audio to see all the podcast episodes with descriptions that include links to their associated videos. Sources cited and other details are available on each video's page. Information about my books, How Not to Die, How Not to Diet, and How Not to Age is at nutritionfacts.org/books. And as always, all proceeds I receive from the sales of all my books goes to charity. And sign up for my free newsletter at nutritionfacts.org/subscribe to stay updated on the latest bite-sized videos and articles. Nutritionfacts.org is a science-based nonprofit. Everything on the website is free. There are no ads, no corporate sponsorships, no kickbacks, strictly non-commercial, not selling anything. Just put it up as a public service, as a labor of love, as a tribute to my grandmother, whose own life was saved with evidence-based nutrition. Thanks for listening.